Welcome to the House of Lords European Union Committee. My name is Tim Boswell and I chair this committee. And its job is to scrutinise all the documents that are generated as part of the European process. We scrutinise the work of our government and the explanations they offer for them. And we scrutinise the work of the European Union institutions which may have proposed them. And our objective in doing this is to contribute to first better lawmaking and better policies, and secondly a much better public understanding of what is done by our government and by Europe in our name. Every week we consider all the documents which are deposited by our government in Parliament which come from a European source. And each of those documents is accompanied by an explanatory memorandum, EM for short, from our government, which is meant to explain what is proposed and what the effect will be. We then, as a committee, scrutinise those proposals. We very often enter into correspondence with government to clarify them. From time to time, we will ask a minister to come and explain them to us. We'll also talk to the various other interested parties likely to be affected by those proposals. And it's an effective process because our government has agreed that they will not give formal consent in Brussels to anything unless and until our committee is satisfied that they understand what is proposed. As well as our core scrutiny work, our committee also conducts longer inquiries into matters which involve the European Union and are of current interest to this country and its citizens. Recent examples have included food waste, judicial cooperation, future enlargement of the European Union, and many others are conducted. The idea is that we should start with a call for evidence. People should then submit their written evidence, and as well as that written evidence, we will typically take public evidence on the record in public evidence sessions. And this will build up a picture of evidence. And we use that evidence and we draw on that evidence for the committee to make its report on each of these issues and to issue recommendations. The British government is obliged to respond to those recommendations promptly, and after that there will be a debate in the House of Lords on them. Of course, what we do doesn't just end with scrutiny or reports. We issue and even debate. Our interest continues because the issues continue to be important. And we carry them out, sometimes returning again and again to the same issue, pressing to ensure that the policies of our government are vigorously represented in Brussels. Finally, frankly, there's no point in doing all this work unless we can communicate effectively what we're doing. And to that end, I want to emphasise that we put a great deal of effort both into our website but also into all the publications that we may prepare and make available. They are available through our website and you can pick up the evidence for inquiries, text of current reports and so forth from them. We're also happy to communicate through Twitter. If you have a query, please get in touch with us. It's very much in our interest that people should give us feedback, and we want to ensure a better debate on all these things from an informed public.